ANSTO analyzes the world at the scale of an atom, and its research techniques are helping to reveal the secrets of past climates and detect pollution not visible to the human eye. ANSTO's research instruments can detect atoms of elements within vast environmental systems, such as waterways and the air we breathe. These techniques are so precise they could detect a glass of wine if it was dropped into Sydney Harbour. We generally can't see the carbon pollution in the air we breathe, and we also can't see the microplastics in our waterways. But this area of science is helping us to see the unseen. It means we can fully understand what is happening to our environment in order to manage it in a more sustainable way for the future. There are few more important issues for humans than the quality of the air we breathe. So ANSTO is monitoring the air at Cape Grim in Tasmania for two air pollution studies.
Cape Grim is one of only three what they call premier baseline stations. Our radon detector at Cape Grim is the most accurate, the most precise radon detector in the world. And so it's a very good location to have that detector.
The world-leading science undertaken by the ANSTO radon team here at Cape Grim is fundamental in characterising the nature of the samples measured here, and in particular determining the clean air samples off the Southern Ocean.
With the help of CSIRO and the Met Bureau, we've been measuring fine particles using this instrument here since 1991. This is a cyclone unit that separates out the fine particles, which are 2.5 microns in diameter. That is, you can put 100 of these across the diameter of a human hair. These particles come from fine combustion in products like cars and general industry and burning. Of course, we don't have much of that here at Cape Grim, so we can get baseline data, but we can use this baseline data to compare with what we get in our other dozen sites around New South Wales and throughout Asia.
Australia is the driest inhabited continent on the planet. Therefore, water research is essential to helping us manage this precious resource.
At ANSTO, we use isotopic and nuclear science techniques to understand our water resources. We can use these techniques to trace contamination sources, to understand how much groundwater we have, and then provide this information to farmers.
In the water that's been recharged into the groundwater, there's a chemical signature which comes from the rainfall event, but also comes from the rock that it's been dissolving out. And that gives us an idea of how the groundwater has flowed through an aquifer and the age of the aquifer.
My research has been focused on metal uptake by different organisms, so metals coming from predominantly mining sources. We plan to produce a radioisotope tracer of microplastics here at ANSTO so that I can follow how plastic particles that are really tiny get eaten by different animals, from mussels and oysters all the way up to fish, using radioisotopes and nuclear techniques applied to microplastics. We should be able to get a much better understanding as to whether plastics get into our marine food chain.
We receive samples from right around the world. They could be, they're predominantly liquid samples, they're water samples, but we do extend beyond that. They could be soil samples, corals, soil cores. And the aim for this is to understand processes. The main thing is that could be a straight environmental process. It's in a natural system, so we can see the change in climate. We can see a man-made sort of impact that has occurred, say in a soil core partway down, and we can see what's happened before and what's happened afterwards. Or it could be a process itself, which is an industrial process itself. So we want to improve their particular system that they're wanting to work with. So some of our clients include universities. They could be university students, they could be academics. And we do also train a number of students that come through in some of the technique, and they go on then, of course, they can become collaborators with us, and that may go overseas. They may go overseas and we continue that at the international stage and not just the national. Or they could be something like BlueScope Steel or some sort of big, reputable, if you like, industrial company, and they're coming to us for that sort of work as well.
ANSTO studies the Earth in many different ways.
We're here at the Huon River in Tasmania, next to a Huon pine. Now, this particular pine tree began growing in 1546. How do we know that? We used a tool like this to take a wood core from the sample and counted the rings. But trees like this contain not only a record of ring widths and climate history, but they also contain radiocarbon that's been produced in the atmosphere by natural nuclear processes. And this radiocarbon can tell us a lot about the Earth's past climate and the reasons that the Earth's past climate has changed. And with our tools at ANSTO, our particle accelerators that allow us to actually count individual atoms, we can read these very subtle signals of past climate change. These changes are important to understand because without understanding how the Earth's climate has changed in the past, we cannot reliably predict future climate change.
Flood and drought events have affected Southeast Australia, which have impacted on water resources, ecosystems, regional agriculture, and the economy. Now, wet and dry years are recorded in the chemical signature of speleotherms. However, accurate interpretation hinges on understanding the causes of trace element variability in these cave drip water deposits.
This is a cross-section of a stalagmite, and you can see how the layers of calcite have built up through time. At ANSTO, we use nuclear techniques to reconstruct the geochemical record of the stalagmite, and we use this information to reconstruct how climate has changed in the past and other past environmental information such as fire.
Understanding the past is crucial for our ability to plan for future events.
We have researchers who bring samples from all over the world, and it can be anything from sediment cores to speleotherm samples. They are trying to answer a research question, so ITREX plays a part in solving that equation in terms of what the elemental composition is along their core. Environmental science is like being an environmental detective. Basically, you're trying to solve what might have happened in the past. So if we can learn from the past, we can better plan for our future.
ANSTO's work is helping protect our environment.